1949. Gamekeepers at Holcomb Hall contemplate their dirtied and damaged top hats. Thomas Coke, the first Earl of Leicester, grows tired of their hats being knocked off by branches and trampled by their horses. His gamekeepers still need to look sharp while on the grounds of his estate. He turns to James Locke & Co., a company of hatters, to put their best hatters on the case. Thomas and William Bowler take up the job, and they design a hat so iconic to English lifestyle that it survives to this day. Whether myth or fact, this story is still passed on today as the iconic beginning of the bowler hat. How's it going today, guys? Welcome back to another World Hatstory 101. Today, we're discussing the bowler hat, the true cowboy hat. We'll get to that in just a moment. First, let's talk about some facts that are agreed upon. The hat was invented or designed, however you want to put that, in 1849. That is for sure. However, accounts of how it came to be vary from the story I told before to several different accounts. Another possible belief is that it was actually made for the Earl's brother. Edward Coke paid 12 shillings for the hat after he picked it up from Thomas and William Bowler, and he threw it on the ground and stomped on it twice. Since the hat survived his onslaught, he was extremely happy with its design. The hat has stayed in popularity up until, I would say, the late 20th century, but it survives in several strange locations to this day. The hat is so iconic of the Englishman or the British lifestyle, especially the British businessman, that it has survived indefinitely as an icon to all that it stands for. The bowler hat is extremely rounded. Rounded right over, unlike the top hat or many other hat styles, and as a signature brim, rounded completely around. In more Victorian era times, the brim was a slightly longer and rounded up. With more modern bowlers, they've tended to shrink that brim and keep it nice and tight to the head. Now let's get to some cool and interesting facts about the bowler. The bowler is the real cowboy hat. I'm not joking. It's the bowler hat, despite any other styles, that was the most worn and most requested hat back in the American Wild Wild West. It was so beloved because it could stay on. It would stay on through rough winds, through storms, through riding on horseback, and leaning out of train windows. In America, it took on a different name. Here we call it the Derby hat, and it was extremely popular in the Victorian era and our Wild West era. There are many legends of the West who were very fond of their bowler hats. Bat Masterson, Butch Cassidy, and Billy the Kid. They were almost never seen without their trusty Derby hats. One of them even went back after a shootout to retrieve their very hat. It was favored by the Wright brothers when they were testing their airplanes, again for its ability to stay on, and it's just a staple of the American Victorian era as well. Almost as popular as the very top hat that we talked about in our last episode. Oh, but nothing compares to my favorite weird fact about the bowler. Let's talk about Bolivia for a second. In Bolivia, starting around the 1920s, Bolivian women actually took a liking to the bowler hat. In Spanish, they actually call it the bombín, and it became a very prominent women's fashion in Bolivia, to the point where it survives to this very day as a prominent women's fashion. In fact, they love it so much, and it's such ingrained part of their culture. They actually used to import a lot of their bonbons from Italy, but when the factories stopped creating them due to the lack of popularity, they actually opened up hatters in their own areas so that they could keep the production of bowler hats going. They acquired the taste from British railroad workers who came into the area to work on the railroad, and it's never left since. And it is adorable, and I love them. Now, I only have one bowler myself, a very simple black low-to-my-head bowler. I did buy it at nethats.com, but you can find bowlers in a variety of locations. Nathats.com have different colors and different sizes of bowlers and derbies depending on your needs. There's also a lot of places like Steampunk Emporium and other locations online where you can find a bowler that more fits your needs. And with that, that ties up this video on World Hatstory 101. If you want to see more episodes of World Hatstory 101, like, share, and subscribe. That helps out the channel a ton. If you want to see more World Hatstory, definitely check out our other videos. If you want to see more steampunk content, check out the rest of my channel. I have event videos, I have other steampunk videos, and we're going to be making more videos to come. If you see me at an event near you, please feel free to say hi no matter what I'm doing. I try to get out as much as possible in the New England community, and I hope to see you at an event. And with that, I'm signing off. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and stay fancy.